evolution of hacking. The word hacker has an overwhelmingly negative meaning these days, conjuring up pictures of cyber thefts intent on stealing identities and unleashing disruptive viruses into the internet. This was not always the case. In fact, computer hackers were originally viewed by society as technology enthusiasts who wanted nothing more than to optimize, customize, and tinker. It wasn't until decades later, with the emergence of viruses and cybercrime, that traditional hackers were grouped in with those who hacked with bad purpose. And the public demonization of hacking started. Curious about the origins of this evolution? As are we, which is why we made the decision to research the background of hacking. But before we jump into the video, welcome to Shark Tech Channel. We provide you with the latest updates and news and all that's happening in the tech world straight from the horse's mouth. Let's dive right in. 1960s. It's interesting to note that the word hack is not a computer term. Instead, it began with MIT's Tech Model Railroad Club in 1961, when the club members modified the functions of their advanced railway sets by hacking them. Later, they switched from toy trains to computers, using the elusive and pricey IBM 704s at MIT to experiment, discover, develop new paradigms, and attempt to increase the capabilities of computers. Along with other early hackers, these MIT students were mainly concerned with discovering, enhancing, and testing the boundaries of already developed programs, as was the case with the Unix operating system, developed by Dennis Ritchie and Keith Thompson. In some situations, these hacks even resulted in programs that were significantly superior to the ones that already existed. 1970s. While computer hacking remained popular in the 1970s, the decade also saw the emergence of a new type of hacker, one who experimented with telephone systems. Phone hackers such as the infamous John Draper, dubbed Freakers, exploited operational characteristics in the telephone switching network, which had recently gone completely electronic. Draper famously discovered that a toy whistle found in Cap'n Crunch cereal produced the exact tone needed, 2600 Hz, to indicate to long lines that a line was ready to route a new call. This enabled him and other Freakers to defraud the network and make free long-distance calls. The Freaker subculture spawned not only influential hackers like Draper, but also digital visionaries. Before they went on to found one of the most successful computer companies in the world, Steve Wozniak and Steve Jobs were, in fact, humble phone freakers. 1980s. The introduction of turnkey personal computers to the general public in the 1980s marked a watershed moment in the history of hacking. Computers were no longer restricted to businesses and prestigious universities, but were available to anyone for their own purposes, whatever they may be. Unsurprisingly, the wide availability of personal PCs led to a rapid increase in hackers. It was not the only significant change in the hacking community. While there were still many hackers who were primarily interested in tinkering with operating systems, a new breed emerged who were more concerned with personal gain. They exploited their technological expertise to commit crimes, such as pirating software, making viruses, and hacking into systems to steal private data, rather than using it to improve computers. The time it took the law to react was short. The Federal Computer Fraud and Abuse Act, the first law specifically addressing hacking, was quickly passed in response to the advent of cybercriminals in 1986. At the same time, the notion of hackers as digital geniuses, capable of both good and bad deeds, started to permeate popular culture. The concept was popularized by a variety of books and movies, most famously the 1983 film War Games, in which a suburban youngster discovers a backdoor in a military central computer and almost sparks World War III. 1990s. The 90s were the decade when hacking really started to become well-known, riding the wave of significant advancements that took place in the 1980s. The term hacker was tarnished by an ever-rising number of cybercrimes done by crackers, or malicious hackers, and the high-profile arrests that followed. Some of the more well-known crackers of the decade include Kevin Mitnick, Kevin Polson, Robert Morris, and Vladimir Levin. They were all apprehended and found guilty of crimes like stealing proprietary software from well-known companies, tricking radio stations into giving away expensive cars, starting the first computer worm, and organizing the first digital bank heist. 2000s. In the 2000s, ethical hackers' good name was dragged through the mud as malicious hackers' attacks dominated the headlines. New and dangerous types of hacks have emerged, affecting government entities as well as prominent businesses. Massive denial-of-service attacks brought down Microsoft, eBay, Yahoo, and Amazon, while the Department of Defense and the International Space Station had their systems breached by a 15-year-old boy. 2010s. With the world now firmly established in the digital age, the hacking community has become more sophisticated, complicated, and complex than ever before. Lone wolf hackers and small hacking groups can still be found in every corner of the internet. Depending on their hat, optimizing software or launching ransomware and Wi-Fi attacks. However, hacktivist organizations such as Anonymous have taken center stage in this decade, releasing highly classified documents, exposing government secrets, and leading vigilante digital crusades in the name of protecting the public from being harmed, exploited, or withheld information. In reaction to both hacktivists and cybercriminals, government entities and big corporations are scrambling to improve security, while computer giants work hard to tweak their systems. While cybersecurity experts are constantly being recruited, systems upgraded, and technology innovated, hackers, both good and bad, consistently and predictably stay one step ahead. What hackers are targeting for today? 1. Public Wi-Fi. Hackers seek out real-world locations with lax security, such as coffee shops, train stations, and retail outlets. A hacker can easily create a spoof hotspot that unsuspecting users will log into, allowing the hacker to gain access to data from connected devices. Furthermore, a man-in-the-middle attack can be used to intercept data between a server and a client, allowing the hacker to capture passwords. 2. Mobile phones. Our phones contain everything from passwords to financial data, which makes our mobile devices another major hacking target. And with the pandemic, businesses have seen a significant increase in employees using their own mobile devices for work. While a bring-your-own-device policy has significant benefits for both the employee and the employer, it can also mean that confidential company data ends up residing on employee devices, which may not have the same level of security as IT-controlled devices. Because people are on their phones all the time and are often checking them while doing something else, personal mobile devices can be particularly vulnerable to social engineering schemes that depend on the user to click a malicious link sent via email or text. This link can then trigger the download of malware that can be used to spy on the user, trigger a ransomware attack, or allow a hacker to burrow their way into a company's network. Number 3. Social media. Users voluntarily share large amounts of personal details on their social media channels. While this is a great way to keep up with friends and family, it also makes it easy for hackers to use that information for cybercrimes, such as account takeovers, where hackers can publicly share information to guess the answers to common security questions, allowing the hacker to reset the password, change the email address, and take over an account. This also includes spear phishing, which is when a criminal can use the information posted on social media to create a fake online identity designed to gain the victim's trust. Once they are trusted, they often manipulate the victim into sending money or gift cards. In the corporate world, hackers can use social media information of specific executives to induce them to reveal confidential information, provide access, or send funds. Number 4. Cryptocurrency. As hackers compete to conduct ever larger hacks, they're also finding it easier to get paid thanks to cryptocurrencies. Crypto is nearly untraceable, which means cybercriminals can accept ransomware payments in cryptocurrency and not have to worry about authorities discovering their identity. However, crypto isn't foolproof. There are examples where law enforcement has been able to track and recover crypto payments. In 2021, authorities recovered $2.3 million of the crypto ransom paid by Colonial Pipeline. In addition to using crypto to accept ransomware payments, hackers are also taking over devices and using them to mine cryptocurrency. This lets them take advantage of the victim's CPU and electricity bill to create crypto for free. So, there you have it, the evolution of hacking. Let us know in the comments below. If you found this video helpful, make sure to like and subscribe to our channel to get the latest updates. Thanks for watching, and see you soon in the next video.